Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes of this podcast, we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D, and today's 3D modeling tool is called Untriangulate. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how this works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. I have the sphere here. If you want to make your own sphere, you can do that by holding down a click on this cube and you'll see your primitives are right here. We can drop in a sphere and adjust the number of segments of the sphere, as well as change it to an icosahedron, and it'll look more like mine. So if you adjust the segments here, you'll see something a little bit closer to mine. And then you can hit the Make Editable button, or the hotkey for that is C. And that is how you can get something similar to what I have on my screen. I'll delete that sphere for right now and focus on this one. Untriangulate helps you remove triangles from your model, and the hotkey for it is UU. If you hit the U button, you'll see a drop-down menu appear on your screen, and you'll see under U, it says Untriangulate. And that is how we know the hotkey for this tool is UU. So I'll hit U twice, and now we have it open in our Attributes Manager. Our first option here is Create N-gons. And what this will do is it'll take triangles and it'll create N-gons in order to remove those triangles. So that is one option of how you can remove triangles from your mesh. Another option is to leave this unchecked and it will only create quads instead of N-gons. N-gons are polygons with more than four edges. So what we'll do here is just show what happens when you check this box. When we check this box here, you'll see that we no longer have the internal angle as an option or the alignment angle as an option, but we still have the flatness angle here that we can adjust. I'll hit apply just so that you can see what's happening to the sphere. And as I slowly increase this angle, this flatness angle, you'll begin to see changes happening to our mesh. So now you can see we've started combining some triangles. As we increase that flatness angle, when we increase it even further, even more triangles are removed. If we increase it too far, our sphere completely collapses, and that is a problem. So what is this flatness angle even doing? What is it? And why is it making our sphere collapse? Well, I'm going to show you a little bit of the math behind it and what it is. So for right now, I'm just going to undo that and click away. And I'll zoom in on our sphere over here, and you can see that we have these two triangles that I'm going to use as an example. This one and this one. I'll go ahead and grab my doodle tool over here, doodle paint tool, and you'll see it shows up in our attribute manager. I'm going to keep it on red, size 3, and I'm going to go ahead and draw a little bit of an illustration to help you understand what a flatness angle is. So here I'm going to draw the normal of this triangle and the normal of this triangle. So this is the normal direction of this triangle. And this is the normal direction of this triangle. These two triangles are adjacent to each other. If we were to extend these normal lines for both of these triangles at some point in 3D space, they're going to intersect right here, and then we can form an angle right here. And this angle is called your flatness angle. When you're adjusting that angle, for your flatness angle, you are choosing the max allowable deviation of normal angles between adjacent triangles to create n-gons or quads. When you choose this number of degrees, you're basically choosing a constraint of at what point this can create an n-gon or quad. And it determines that with this flatness angle. So I hope that helps you understand a little bit of why when we increased that number so much, it completely collapsed. Basically, the further you increase that degree, the more likely, or the more triangles will be removed. But if you increase it too far, you do run the risk of having your shape collapse like we saw earlier. So just be careful about that when you're using it. So I'm going to delete our doodle tool for right now, and we're going to move on to some other settings within this tool. So I'll hit UU again in order to pull up this panel. I'm going to turn off Create N-gon. And now you can see we have other options here. Internal angle, alignment angle. I'll increase that to 180 degrees for right now and hit apply. So now what it's doing is it is trying to create quads, and you can think of these angles as constraints of what kinds of angles will be permitted when creating quads, in order to create quads. So if I start decreasing these, you can see that the constraints are becoming too much, and now we're back to having a bunch of triangles. But let's talk about what these actually are and what they're doing, and some of the math behind it in case if you want to totally understand. So in order to show this, I'm going to go over here to this surface. You can see it's not perfectly planar, and I'm going to click on it. Now we have an internal angle and an alignment angle to go over. I'll grab my doodle paint tool again, and I'll keep it red again. Imagine if this line extended beyond this point, so all the way over here. And imagine if this line extended beyond this point over here. And then this angle here would be your alignment angle. Okay, so this is our alignment angle, and this angle defines the max allowable angle deviation for the resulting quad. Hopefully that gives you an idea of how that works. If that's confusing to you, that's totally okay. Just understand that as you increase those number of degrees, you are allowing Cinema 4D to also remove more triangles, and this is one of the methods it's using. It's just constraints on angles while you're removing triangles from your model and turning them into quads. So this one is just for quads and not for creating n-gons. Quads are polygons with four edges. Triangles are polygons with three edges. And we have another kind of angle called the internal angle. And the internal angle, I'll make a different color. Maybe I'll make it a dark blue color. And the internal angle is this angle in here. So the internal angle, this defines the degree this angle can deviate from 90 degrees to create a quad. So you're determining if the quads that are being made in your model from those triangles, how much they can deviate from 90 degrees. So you're determining that internal angle. I hope that that gives you a better idea of what's happening when we're adjusting those angles in there. I'll go ahead and remove this. And we'll go back over to our sphere. And if I hit UU again, you'll see that we have some more options down here. We have keep UV boundary. Basically, what this means is that if you have UV mapped a model and you have UV islands, and here's an example of what a UV island is. It's when you have a texture applied to your model, but you flatten it out on 2D and it wraps around a 3D object, and the different parts of that UV map are separated into islands. Our next option is keep Phong edge breaks. I have another tutorial where I go in depth of what Phong edge breaks are, all of the 3D modeling tools related to Phong, and what the Phong tag does. So if you're interested in that, I'll leave that in the description. But basically what this means is that as you're reducing triangles, you'll be keeping your Phong edge breaks. It won't remove those as it's removing triangles and changing them to quads. Keep mesh attributes. Now this is a fun one. I'm going to show you what this is. If I right click on our sphere and I go under to other tags, you'll see an option here called vertex color. I'm going to click on that and now our sphere has turned to black, but we can paint on it and it's automatically opened up the paint tool for us. So I can go ahead and start painting on our sphere. I can use multiple colors. We can do some kind of ombre effect here if we'd like. Now we have a beautiful ombre sphere. Now the way UV color, the way the vertex color tag works is that it will apply color and determine where that color goes based on the points in your mesh. So it is applying color by the points. So the more points you have on your mesh, the more detailed color you can apply. Now, with that said, you could imagine that since we're applying color to the points, what if we start removing triangles? Would we run the risk of also changing the color on this sphere? So that's where this tool comes into play. If we hit the hotkey UU again for untriangulate, we have keep mesh attributes on, and we can hit apply, and it has kept our color data from here. The vertex color tag, this data is being kept and respected within this model because we have keep mesh attributes on, and that's what it's referring to. Is this color, is this vertex color tag. Those are the mesh attributes it is keeping. I hope this helps you better understand how to use untriangulate in order to remove triangles from your mesh. Some reasons for removing triangles from your mesh could be that the topology of quads are easier to 3D model with. Sometimes 3D modeling with triangles can be challenging. Quads are easier to work with when it comes to subdivision surface modeling as well. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, please give me a thumbs up or subscribe so that you'll be notified when the next tutorial comes out. And thank you so much for watching.